Okay, welcome once again to today's guitar lesson edition. Today we are doing a lesson called modes. We are continuing from where we left the modes lesson. We did the last time difference between Ionian and Dorian mode. So today we are taking a look at Phrygian. That is the third mode. First mode is Ionian, second is Dorian, third is Phrygian. That is, I don't play like my Aunt Lucy. That is the words we use for them. So I for Ionian. Don't, D for Dorian. So we are on the P, play. That is Phrygian mood. When we say moods, let's go to the guitar board. We'll do deep lesson as we've done in the previous ones. So let's go and look at how it is interesting modes. If you do understand them well, it's interesting. On this topic, that's the reason why we use C, because it is the mother of all keys. So sometimes we have to use them the key C before we go to other keys, that making the lesson very interesting and easy to follow. So let's do C here, C chord. So the so first is, so that is do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do, re, mi. Re do ti la so fa mi. In the C shape here. C in the C shape. That is the cage system C shape. So before we do anything, we have to rehearse on the C surface. Or the Ionian mode. That is do re mi fa so la ti do ti la so fa mi re do. Take your time. We have a lot of lessons, tons of lessons on this sofa playing. That is the do re mi fa. That is, we have done a whole lot on cage system. So if you are new to this lesson, please, it's better to understand the cage system, the surface, everything before you come back to this lesson. So let's continue, or else it will be like every day we are on the same topic or the same lesson. So let's go. This is C, do, re, mi, fa. It's like we are working on the one on one string. So la ti do ti la so fa mi re do. And we've done do, that is the Ionian, that do re mi. So it's the shape that we are taking a look at it. When we say mode, it deals with the shape of the surface we are playing. So here we are on the mi fa so. So that will be the first three, fa so here. So you see, we break that mi to do, and the mi is E, F, G. So the E, F, G, that is mi, fa, so. We have to bring it here. So take your time. Mi, fa. It has given us do, D, mo. So let's continue. Do di mo. So mi fa so la ti do re mi. You see the shape. So semitone, tone. That is the meaning of the Phrygian mode. So mi fa so la ti do re mi. Again, mi, re, do, ti, la, so, fa, mi. So we are copying this shape exactly to see or the do, because we've started on the mi. So we are sending this same thing to do. So let's take a look at it carefully. Mi, fa, so, la, ti, do, re, mi. So let's take it to see. You see, it has given us do to do in the key C. So it has given us do, di, mo, fa, so, zi, do, do. Phrygian mode, and I've already said differentiate the minor scale and major scale, the difference between them. When we say a scale is minor, it has more. Any scale that has more is a minor scale. Any scale that has mi rather instead of more is a major. So that do re mi is a major. Do di more or do re more. Do more is a minor. So the fact it has the more here. So you see, it's a minor. That is minor. Do the more. So it's a minor. And in the previous lesson, I said something. That whatever scale sometimes we play reflects a major scale for a certain key. So if you take a look at it, that is do, di, mo, fa, so, si, do, do. You can see it's G sharp major. Because if you use this half major, it has been do, ti, la, so, fa, mi. If you add a re, do, so, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do, re, mi. You see? So, whenever you reach mi, which scale gives us C sharp, a C as mi? That is another meaning. So, in learning of the modes, there are a whole lot of approaches that one can use it. I've already said one. The first one is do, re, mi, si. So, mi, fa, so. So, we use mi and bring the whole thing. Mi, fa, so, to. So, it has given us G sharp as do. So, secondly, which scale gives us C as mi? Which key gives C as mi? You have it. Mi, re, do. So it's G sharp. So mi, re, do. So mi, re, do. Ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do. But the whole word at the solo, or when we want to resolve to do, or the root, it means you have to play to mi. That is the basic understanding of the modes. That is why I say sometimes it's very controversial topic, difficult topic to understand. But if you have the shortcut, the guess, the meaning of exactly what you mean, there is no way you cannot play. So I'm making it very easy and comfortable to play. So let's say we are playing C, because so it means we know that the G sharp major is a C Phrygian scale. But if you want to use the C itself, it is do, di, mo, fa, so, si, do, 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 si, so, fa, mo, di, do. So any C we go to play do, di, mo, fa, so, si, do, do. Enough said that if you want to make it simple and short without remembering the do, di, mo, zi, and others, just take a key that has C sharp, a C as me, make you do me. So, me, re, do. So, you see, it's G sharp major. This is G sharp. Because we have on the fourth string D, D sharp or E flat, E, F, F sharp, G. This is G sharp. You see, you get me? Do you get me? This is C. Because open is G, G sharp, A, A sharp or B flat, B. This is C. So do ti la so fe mi re do ti la so fe mi re do. This is the C Ionian mode or C major scale. And we want to play C Phrygian scale. So it means do when we go to G sharp do. You see, so you want to play C. Sometimes people choose, or jazz players choose, to play a minor scale over minor chord rather than playing it over a major chord. But creating tension, you can create tension by playing a minor scale over a major chord or a major scale over minor chord. That is why you want to create some sort of tension for yourself. So this is, we can play C minor. C minor, this is C minor, do, so, do on the fifth string, so, on the fourth string, sixth position, then do, on the third string, sixth position, then we have more, on the second string, fourth fret, then we have so, on the first string, third position, so, this is the chord. So sometimes when I mention the names, take your pen and paper, write something down as a reference guide. That will help you remember exactly what we mean. So any G sharp on the board, we can play over this chord or C. That is the application of the Phrygian scale. So either I play this to create tension, or when a chord is played C major, I will play as tension. Or I will use the minor itself, because the scale is a minor scale. Resolved the chord very harmonically. But when we want to create tension, this is tension. So we will create chord. The scale is a minor scale, then we play it over a major chord, giving us a tension. So the same thing, we have G sharp, do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do here. Have the G sharp scale here. So as I've said, when we use the G sharp in our reference, it means our solo must end me, do ti la so fa mi. If you go G sharp, me, any G sharp, we know we go and play, then the phrase will end on Mi. But you see, we are playing do G la so fa mi re do here in the G shape of playing in the K system. Do but do. You see, whenever we play it, when we go to Mi in the G sharp, it has given us C. So that is the basic understanding one must have or to learn, so that it will make the lesson very easy and interesting to follow. So whenever we are playing, we have to resolve to me. So better ski. So whenever we go to move to G sharp here, for C chord, over C major chord, over C or over C minor chord, it's better to understand exactly. This is just an overview. I want you to understand the principle, because we will go to use and play over chord changes. But if you do not understand, and I say here, we have to use Phlegian scale, or you have to use Dorian mode here, or this mode here, you will get lost. That is the reason why I've taken time slowly for you. So it is two-way. Either you take your G sharp, but all the solos will be ending on the Mi, or you take your C, but you play Do, Di, Mo, Fa, So, Si, To, Do. That way you can use, so whenever you, wherever on the board you have your C, you have to do a calculation. Do, Di, Mo, Fa, So, Si, To, Do, Di. So you see, you have to calculate your notes. If you have it here, you calculate. If you have it, you have to calculate it yours. Or making it simple, just take your G sharp and the solo will on the Mi. So you make your Do, the C here, Mi. So this is the introduction to the Phlegian, the understanding. I don't want you to play. That is the reason why the solos I played, I didn't slow it and play for you to play the same thing. No, the main understanding is what I want you to know, because you will continue. Rina, my friend, my Kenyan friend, I can see you like the modes very well. So Biko Rinya also, so just forgive me, I will write your name next time, mention it well, collect for you. So let's do the understanding, because after this, if you finish the I don't play like my Aunt Lucy, that is Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian dominant, Locrian, those, we finish the modes, we will come back for the application. So it's better to get the meaning of exactly what we are doing. As for the board work, I'm sure this time everybody is with me, because we've done cage system for not less than 3 times. So if you get lost, go back to the cage system, the surface, everything on the board, so that you, when you come back to the modes, you will not get lost. You do understand everything we are doing. That's the reason why we use C all the time for the lessons. So thank you very much for joining me in this lesson. We shall meet very soon for the continuity. That is the Lydian dominant. We will do the same thing, the Locrian, Mesolydian, all the skills we will do. When we finish, we come back to its a proper application over chord changes. That is the rhythm. When we say rhythm, it's chord changes. Somebody say you should answer a question on jazz, so you go soon for the jazz lesson. So thank you for joining me in this lesson.